Okay, so this is the Park and Lock podcast, podcast number 3, but today Andy wasn't feeling good, and so we weren't actually going to be able to do this today, but me and my buddy, the Reverend Scotty D over here.
Hey, just call me Scotty like you usually do, that's my full title.
All right, me and Scotty have been sitting here drinking, and he's like, well, man, I'll help you with this pot. If you would like to do the podcast, I would actually be down to do something like this. So I was like, all right, we're going to try to do a show to the best of what we can. Who knows? It could be long, short. We'll see what's up, and we're going to go with it, and we hope you enjoy it. Are you ready to do this?
Let's go.
All right. Okay, so let's see. Got my notes here. Let's see what I'm going to do first for the first question. You don't like live-action remakes of certain things, or you don't like... You were talking earlier, like, if something's a cartoon, you don't want to see a live-action of it, do you?
Not necessarily. It doesn't always translate well to live.
Okay.
Action. I think, you know, it's just... Especially when you grew up reading comic books, I was like I did, and even into my adulthood. You know, you have certain images of these things in your head, and you'd rather see maybe just a really well-done, you know... Many pictures per second, high quality, full animation.
Would be so you would awesome. Rather see like you would rather see a Batman Superman movie animated than live action?
Probably. And yeah. Sometimes
done well.
You know. Yeah.
So
yeah.
Like were there you know the comic book The Killing Joke, correct?
Oh, I have. Okay. First edition, baby.
They're making that into a movie that comes out this summer. Kevin Conroy, that did Batman's voice in the animated series, is doing Batman's voice, I believe. But Mark Hamill is actually doing the Joker's voice.
I read something about that.
Well, the cartoon is going to be an R-rated cartoon. And it's going to be an R-rated Batman Killing Joke cartoon.
Yeah, I will watch that.
Yeah, exactly. So, and I'm with you on that. But, do you know who Robert Rodriguez is? He did Sin City, okay. Planet Terror.
He was the director?
Yeah.
Okay.
He did Once Upon a Time in Mexico, Desperado.
Okay.
He did From Dusk Till Dawn. Things like that. So
wait, what's Once Upon a Time in Mexico?
That you know the movie Desperado with Antonio Banderas, El Mariachi, the guitar player with the guns.
Oh, those three
he
movies.
Did, yeah, he did,
oh,
exactly.
Okay.
He did that whole series.
Oh,
so, yeah, okay. That's Robert Rodriguez.
I like those movies, especially the original. I mean, Antonio's great and everything, but the original, I don't know, what's the
El Mariachi.
Name? Yeah, El Mariachi, the guy.
He shot it completely on $5,000 in all basically one takes. That's crazy.
Yeah.
And so, I really like him as a director, man. I really dig Robert Rodriguez. He's doing what I believe to be a live-action Johnny Quest movie. And it's like, it's an animated movie, and I really like it.
It's an animated movie?
Well, I don't know. No, I mean, it's an animated show, my bad. The cartoon, I mean, it's a cartoon. I don't know if it was a comic before that. I think it was just a Hanna-Barbera cartoon back in the day, right?
I believe it was Hanna-Barbera.
Yeah, so, it's like, considering it's a cartoon, do you think he could do a good live-action of it? It's like, he's a pretty good director. You saw, I don't know if you read Sin City or you saw the movie Sin City.
Yeah, and you know what, honestly, and might have something to do with Christina Ricci being, and I've always found her very attractive being in it, and her as Speed's girlfriend really kind of made me happy to watch her.
Really?
Because I think she's really cute. So, that was part of the hook for me. But I did... For some stupid reason.
Wait, Christina Ricci wasn't in Sin City?
No, Speed Racer.
That was the Wachowski brothers.
Yeah, but I'm saying as far as the translation.
Oh, the anime. Oh, yeah. That wasn't a bad movie either.
The way they did it, but see, Speed Racer is extremely cartoony. Anyway.
That's very, yeah. So, but they went full-blown cartoon.
So it was neat. And like I said, I like the casting. And Christina Ricci is just a very attractive woman.
It.
And her as Trixie.
Dug it.
That was, you know, nothing wrong with that. She is an adult woman. But that combination of...
Who plays... Oh, I remember who plays Speed Racer now.
She was very, very cute in that movie.
Yeah, man. All right.
Pleasure to watch.
So you do believe that...
You were pleasure to watch in that movie. And everything you do, you really are, but...
So then you do believe that he can do a good Johnny Quest movie then. If it's done right, we could have a good...
Yeah, depending on how you want to go with it. How do you want to go with it? You know, I'm picturing it... I mean, God, film it and... Gosh, sorry.
Yeah, you're listening to God. It's okay. No, do you think it would be filmed somewhere in like Brazil in an actual jungles and like kind of an adventure?
See, the way I would do it, the coolest to me, but you know, I'm old, is to film it grainy 60s B-movie style. And like,
really?
You know, even have the...
Well, you know, kind of like how Tarantino would do it.
Well, and you know Robert Rodriguez is good
for that.
But not
Tarantino on the side of the terror, but the...
But nah, but him and Tarantino proved that they can... Because think of, he does the machete movies. So it's like he can make that look like a B-movie, and that he knows how to make it look like a B-movie professionally, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's like, I guess that would be nice, but now...
Something like that, that's how I'm picturing it, but that's me.
All right, now here's my question. Okay, now here's the actual question. What obscure... What property would you like to be seen... Would you like to be made into, like, see as a live-action movie? It could be a cartoon, it could be a book, like... What
something off the beaten path, or
well, let's go since it's cartoons. Like, what
I think
is
you
some,
know my
of car- some of the cartoony? What is it? Is it what you said earlier today?
The Venture Brothers, which is a Johnny Quest parody.
It is.
I like how they incorporated the characters in there. Remember
I know.
Johnny
Quest
still had
like
down
a
in the pod in, underneath the ocean. You're a doctor, man, right?
Man,
something like
yeah.
that. Like,
who do you think could do a Venture Brothers movie?
Oh gosh, see, I'm not as learned in the
true
video arts as you.
All right,
are
I'm trying to think of who could do a good. I'll tell you, the guy that does.
How about the guys who really do it?
For real,
yeah, the guys who created it.
They would. That's true. If they wrote the story,
yeah, and then
that would be good.
It?
Nah, you'd have to get somebody good to direct, man.
Oh, golly whiz!
I think the guy whoever does I don't know if you've seen it. Did you watch the 21? Did you watch the 21?
It's not Snoozledorf. So
it's not Snoozledorf.
It's not Spilling Gold.
That's true,
next
man.
Next time I'm going to get a little bit and bring it over. At least
well, I thought you were
going to
bring the Snoozledorf this round.
Yeah, I've got some. I've got the hookup.
All right. I expect Snoozledorf.
Favorite beer.
Next time you're on the show.
All right, next
hashtag
time.
Hashtag Snoozledorf.
Yep.
Oh, man. But have you watched the 21 Jump Street movie? The newer one, it, like,
yeah,
came out,
yeah,
okay.
And then the second one, or,
yeah, 22, yeah.
I mean, it was amusing in parts for me. Like Ice Cube is the principal,
true,
or
the
head of the,
he's
yeah,
like the main captain, or
the head of the division.
But I think those whoever makes those movies, I think they can make. Oh, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
I think they can make a really okay Venture Brothers movie, man. I think they got the raunchy comedy down. That given the opportunity of a cast, I think maybe those guys could do it okay. Because we need, or even maybe Judd Apatow that does like Super Bad or something. Or actually, I know who would be.
I really like that movie. And it was so funny. When I first saw adverts for it, I thought, this is stupid crap. But it really was written by older guys and from that perspective. And it was just neat. And there was a fantasy element to it, you know,
yeah,
cops and whatnot. And but I was really amused by that movie. I'm sure, you know. It's...
Have you seen Shaun of the Dead?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so you know...
Really loved it.
All right, Simon Pegg and... I feel like a dick for not knowing...
His buddy, the larger
fellow?
Yeah,
Ed.
He's pretty funny, too, though.
No, not the larger guy. The guy that actually directs the movies, man.
Oh,
man. Right now, I'm having the
Who's his buddy? Who's
moment.
His mate that's in all those movies?
Nick Frost is the
Nick
fat
Frost,
guy.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Like
but I would imagine they would be... That, like, Simon Pegg and... Oh, my gosh, hold on. I can't believe
Simon Pegg is Johnny Quest?
No. Just, I gotta think of the other guy's name. Oh, I'm putting Sean. Oh, no, I remember what I'm doing. Sean. I have been drinking.
What do you want Simon Pegg to do?
Not Simon Pegg. The actual director.
Oops.
Oh, you're good. There we go. Good Lord. I'm gonna feel like a real dick now. Edgar Wright. Oh my God, the director is Edgar Wright. He did
Edgar Wright.
Yeah,
Did
and him and Simon Pegg are the. They wrote Shaun of the Dead. They wrote Hot Fuzz, and they wrote At the World's End. And then Edgar Wright directs these movies.
Yeah,
he did a movie called Scott Pilgrim versus the World, based off of a really weird comic book. Man, and
I have vague.
The movie is so wild and out there. He was also supposed to do the Ant-Man movie, and he wrote pretty much most of the new Ant-Man movie. And so he loves comic books. He makes really good comedy. I could really see him making a Venture Brothers. I think he would, and he would have all the comedy. He probably is a fan of the show. But if you had him and the actual writers of Venture Brothers working on a Venture Brothers movies, yeah, like,
see,
well, you wouldn't. No, you'd have to take actors to do it.
But that's the problem too. Is you're so, you know, translating this stuff, especially with something like that. you're so in love with the voice itself that it's part of the character, especially in Venture Brothers. Those character voices they do, and it might be, you know, one guy doing it at the end, you see eight different voices, but how very distinct and very unique. Excuse me, you can't say very unique. They are unique.
They are.
And I mean, they're all. You want that voice with that character, so yeah, it's hard to.
But I mean, that's also the point. That's of where acting. My mind stops. That's the point of acting. Yeah. Though, you could have an actor that sells that monarch role and really sounds like him and delivers it. Like you can really.
But Dr. Girlfriend.
Exactly. You can, but if you had the actor that can seal the deal on it, like that's the magic of acting and seeing it live action. Like, it's like when that translates through somebody else, like, that wouldn't be bad. But, of course, yeah, it would just have to be done right. I personally...
Come on, minions. Or do any of the guys who write the thing, could they fill some kind of roles?
Because they're doing it anyway, and, you know, they're artistic people.
Are the, are the writers, do they do the voices?
I think so.
Really? I didn't know that.
Yeah, we need to look at it harder. Maybe next time we're together on here, we'll do a little... We're studying, and we'll have names down on what we admire about the creators of the Venture Brothers.
Well, that's true, but I mean, at the same time, like, a lot of the times, it's like, as long as it's the show, ultimately, more than the creators, but it's like, the creators should have the, like, they shouldn't have the ultimate say, because sometimes the creators could not make a movie. Like, that's like saying, just because Robert Kirkman fucking wrote Walking Dead, he could go and actually write the show, and it's like, well, Robert Kirkman probably could, because he's fucking awesome, but it doesn't necessarily translate. It doesn't have to translate. Like, just because they can write a comic book doesn't mean they can write a movie.
Oh, I understand. But I
or not a comic book, a cartoon.
But
I mean, but clearly they're good writers.
Yeah, and at the same time, it's, you know, you can tell, at least I think, there's a lot of love in that show. They really, that's their baby in a way.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know,
I love,
they really feed off each other in creativity, I believe. I can feel that, you know, you
in
feel
that Adventure Brothers, they do Iggy Pop and David Bowie are the same person. Yeah. He turns to the ring. Yeah, like that shit. I think that happened in the second season.
He was
season.
The leader of the guild.
Yeah. Yeah, was that the first season at the end? Or I can't remember.
Second, no, I thought the first season, it was the Easy Rider thing.
Yeah, Easy. Yeah, I completely
like that.
Dude. Yeah. Right. Oh, my God. That's so great. I think, I know you don't play video games, but did you ever play Legend of Zelda back in the day?
I did not. I it was all around me.
Oh, dude, I'm a huge Legend of Zelda fan, but I mean, I played it on Super Nintendo and shit, but my real introduction to this was on the N64 on a game called Ocarina of Time. And it's like, I feel it's one of...
What was the first word?
Ocarina. It's like a flute.
Ocarina of Time.
Yeah, it's a flute that you can travel through time and like do things. It's
but
like
ocarina is a musical instrument.
Yeah, it's like
a woodwind instrument.
Kind of. It's like shaped. Actually, check it. It's shaped kind of like a teardrop with an oval. But
what's its country of origin or region of origin? Do you know?
No, I actually don't, man. I've never looked that up. But it's just the main instrument in this.
See, kids, if you don't know, ask questions.
Yeah. Ocarina. All right, let's see. See?
And it has,
so
like
when
a,
you hold it, you have a thumb and a thumb, and then you have three holes in the front. You have six total, and you blown to the top.
Are you
going to
flash
this
on the screen when we're talking about this?
I actually can, yeah.
Yeah. It's an interesting thing. It's almost like a hollowed out, it looks like
it's
a hollowed
an ancient
out
wind
golf
head
of
type
a club.
It's a vessel flute. A vessel. It's a type of vessel flute. We were talking about vessel earlier. Yeah. But yeah, so...
You create different tones by different finger
movements. Yeah.
And there's...
Place... Hey, it's Italian. It originated in Italy, man.
Italy. All right.
All right.
And we are both part Italian.
Yeah. So that's pretty cool.
Viva Italia.
Yeah. So that's really cool. But yeah, so that's what an ocarina is.
Okay.
But the game
and is that... it has eight holes? Does that have to do with...
It has... Well, no. It's just you have three that you play on the front for this hand because you hold it like this.
Wait, that showed eight holes, I thought.
Well, yeah. Well, there's different types, but
okay,
the main one has three.
Is that name tied into eight?
Oh. I don't know.
Octagon, eight?
I don't know.
Ocarina, Latin,
right? I'm not going to get into this.
I'm saying...
We're getting
educated. Look, wait, go back to the picture.
See.
Go to the picture.
Because you got...
Seven it looks like.
But that's... Yeah, but that's...
And that has somebody there. Eight?
Yeah,
eight,
man.
There.
The one that I owned...
Is there one maybe
six
on the side we don't see there because...
Well, there's ones on the back.
Like I said.
Because the back has...
Okay.
The back has thumb holes for your thumb.
Oh, so it's got 10? So you
yeah
call all your digits.
Yeah,
it's
basically.
For a...
Like I said, see, this one only has six and six, basically. Well,
okay,
four on top. But yeah, and then it has two on the back, and you can make them out of anything, I guess. But yeah, it's... There's multiple types. Yeah, I guess it does have a lot. The one I own, see, that one part is
it,
fucking
what part of Italy is it from?
It didn't say.
Is there more of an in-depth, though?
Probably on Wikipedia.
Wiki.
I'm bound by contract to do that every time he says that.
Does he say Wikipedia again?
Wiki. Wikipedia.
Wiki.
History. All family instruments date back. Ocarina of Time.
Wow.
Oh, importance in Chinese.
Mesoamerican. So it's a cross-cultural thing. Because, you know,
it's just an ancient woodland.
Isn't the bow some, you know, some variation of the bow?
Here's where in 19th century.
The modern one.
Okay. Yeah, it's from Budrio, a town in.
Budrio.
Bologna, Italy. But yeah, so Bologna, Italy.
I believe that's where the type of meat bologna is from.
Is it?
Originally.
All right.
Look at that. Can I look at that town?
Yeah. Up north.
Oh, it's the northeast.
Yeah, it's not south. Yeah.
They don't all like right. us.
All right. So yeah, so anyway, so.
A little history then.
Yeah, that was. We just went into a history lesson. You learned about the Ocarina, which, thank you. That
not
was
the Macarena.
Bad. Not the Macarena, which we should hashtag bring back the Macarena.
Oh.
Yeah. All right. So I'm going to move on to the next question. And it's like, you're a sci-fi dude, right?
Yes.
You're like, okay. So I recently really watched this movie.
Like anything to a degree. I know something.
Yeah. Well, I watched this movie called Ex Machina, and nothing has just made me feel more disgusted in the realm of...
Ex Machina, wasn't that a comic book?
No. Well, yeah. And there's
Machina means machine. What's
yeah.
the X-E-X?
Yeah. I don't know what it means.
What's the X mean?
No.
Is it an exoskeleton? Does this guy wear a thing?
Well, yeah. He has a jet. He can communicate with machines. It's a really interesting
but
comic
he's
book.
Inside, like, an outer shell. There's an outer shell.
No, he wears a jetpack. Okay. But he can communicate. So, in fact, in the comic book... I can't think. I think it's just called Ex Machina. But he stops one of the planes from going into the trade tower
okay.
and prevents it. It's a really crazy comic. Hmm. But okay, so
they made a movie of it.
No.
Oh, it's in
but
the
it would be a really cool movie. Yeah, it's a
really
good comic. Well, yeah, this is just called Ex Machina. The movie is, but it's a really good AI robotic type film. So the question that I would like to ask is, what's your favorite sci-fi robot? Or like your actual favorite sci-fi robot movie, or just your favorite sci-fi robot in general?
Wow.
Yeah, that's a good question, right?
Yeah.
Yeah,
I
dude.
I don't know. I've got to have. I mean, the easy go-to would be R2-D2.
He's cute cheap. And helpful. Well, yeah. Well, but, I think yeah. BB-8's already replaced him. I know you didn't go see the new Star Wars.
No, I have not.
Okay.
Have
well, BB Although, BB-8 outdid R2 because he's a real robot and not a man in a tin can.
Right. Well, you know.
But yeah, R2-D2 is a winner, but who would be your favorite? Because I feel Data would be a way better robot.
But he's an android.
But he still counts as a robot.
Artificial life form. Is
artificial, yeah, okay, yeah. Cool. Any sort.
Okay,
any,
okay.
Because I think my favorite might be RoboCop. I don't know if he counts as a sci-fi robot, but he might personally be
I don't
one
know,
of my favorites.
We'll let it count for this.
It doesn't have to count. If you don't think RoboCop stands as a robot...
He's a cyborg.
But see, are cyborgs
not cyborgs robots? Count, then. We say, oh...
That's what I'm saying. Like, yeah, okay. That's so it's all like, right. Would that count?
So then I'd have to say Luke Skywalker is my favorite, then.
But he's a human.
But he's got an artificial
He's got
hand.
A robotic hand. He's got a robotic
He didn't say
hand.
What percentage.
That's very true. That's very true.
I was just trying to mess with you on that. But, no. Like I said, the go-to would be R2-D2... Maybe, you don't probably won't get this reference. Have you ever seen Herbie the Robot from the Fantastic Four?
Yeah.
I'm Herbie.
Yeah, you know he had like that? A TV face. Or...
He replaced the Human Torch because they don't want to encourage kids going out and burning things.
Is that why he got introduced?
Yeah, and there's been a cartoon Human Torch since and before
yes.
that. But anyway,
yes.
it was a weird...
Okay.
It was strange times with Hanna-Barbera.
It was, man. Does that include those old Marvel cartoons?
They at least did that Fantastic Four that was Herbie the Robot. I'm
okay.
pretty sure.
That's crazy.
If people can contact, you know, if I'm wrong about this, we'll
That's
look it
true.
Up in a minute. But
you can always fact check.
But
we'll see.
But yeah, it was weird to see the Invisible Girl, Mr. Fantastic, and Ben Grimm, you know, the thing with Herbie the Robot, you know, which was about yay big.
What was did they say
aleck.
What Johnny Torch was doing this whole time?
They never referred to him,
so he just didn't exist anymore. Was it now? Did it go into the comic books at all?
John Byrne did something crazy with
yeah.
it. Like, no, he wasn't. It wasn't anything that I forget. I just remember
at the end of one issue, and I somehow, you know, you get distracted when you're a kid and you're reading all these titles and you didn't get the next issue. And I think I got it, you know, retroactively anyway, but John Byrne somehow incorporated him, like, you know, it was one of those end panel teasers. It was like, hee-hee-hee, and you could tell it was Herbie the Robot.
Okay.
So he did something with it, but not, like, a replace.
Is that your favorite?
No, I hated Herbie.
You hate Herbie?
Herbie was a...
What did Herbie do to you?
Herbie was a... he was just kind of a prop comic. Or not prop, well...
Comic relief?
Tried to be.
Just there to help but make it also, more kidified?
He was kind of a sassy robot.
Okay.
Smart aleck. I didn't like him.
Yeah, he's a smug bastard.
Kind of a... Yeah.
Like, you just want to punch him in his TV face.
He was a bit of a smug robot. I would have to refresh myself. We should watch these things before we talk.
We should, but that's the point of this. It's just you remember these references, man. You clearly, it's like I know what you're talking about.
But you do. You have seen pictures of Henry the robot at
Easter. Yeah, I know exactly who you're talking about.
Did you ever hear his voice? It was something stupid like this.
And then remember his mouth was like this.
Just a squiggle on, like a frequency type.
Yeah, yeah.
Or even Okay, so I actually know who my favorite robot is going to be, and it's Cheap. And I know you're not going to know, it's beyond you, but my favorite robot is Alpha 5 from the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers.
What was Alpha 5?
A waste of life is what he was, but man, if
he was a person, though.
No, he was just a robot in the command center with Zordon and all. It was Zordon's second in command.
For you.
All right.
Before they brought Mighty Morphin Power Rangers to the United States, it was a Japanese...
Yes, it started back in the 70s. Super Senta. What was it called?
The Dynamen was what they were called.
No, but I mean, the actual... Like, how all these... Like, these... That's Power Rangers Samurai. That's Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. It's the Power Rangers aspect was called Super Senta. So it was Super Senta Dynamen.
Yeah, but they would... In the show, would refer to them as the Dynamen.
Well, yeah. But it's the actual series was called Super Senta. So that's what the Power Rangers were called, but they were the...
Okay, but they were the Dynamen.
Where those are the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, they were the Dynamen Super Senta.
But at the same time, when they brought that to America, they just filmed the sequences of civilian life and stuff and just took the Japanese clips at first.
That's my robot.
Oh, okay.
Alpha 5.
Okay.
Ay-yi-yi-yi-yi.
Okay. I've seen it.
Yeah, dude.
But, you know, originally, remember, they just filmed, and I think since they've probably done some of the monster stuff
But
originally, they just did the Japanese monster stuff and filmed like the white people. By the time, multicultural Americans.
Well, yeah, but by the time they brought that to America, Power Rangers Super Sentai had been on in Japan since the 70s.
Have you ever seen, like...
Yeah, I've watched
every Power Rangers one of the guys, he's a Japanese guy called Cowboy.
Yeah.
Right, or something, remember? And the dubbed voices are hilarious.
Yeah.
Dynamen, come here. Come on.
Dude, that's in Japan, that's like, if you want to do a Godzilla monster movie type thing, that's the big leagues. If you think of it in baseball, that's the major leagues over there. Before you ever go in the major leagues, you play in the minors, and then that's exactly what Super Sentai was. You either put time in as a monster on that show, or as a Power Ranger, or as a monster, or as the Zord, as the robot.
The same thing happens here, but it's a smaller community there. Yeah,
true.
Yeah.
But yeah, by the time they brought that over, that show had been on since the 70s.
Oh, yeah.
They had so many Power Rangers, and that was the 80s Power Rangers that they gave us in 92. But it was a cool power move, and it stayed consistent.
But I just thought it was funny, too, you know.
Yeah.
Someone like me, who was a little older.
Yeah.
She's like... Wow.
But you would know,
like,
you would know the old, exactly, but you would watch bootleg sci-fi shit, monster movies and shit like that. So it's like you actually knew what it was.
Yeah.
So did you figure out who your favorite robot was?
You know, I'm stuck on R2-D2.
So you're sticking right with R2-D2's your dude.
Yeah, I know as soon as we're done here I'm gonna think of something else.
Probably. But I like it. Stick with it. What about the robot
comic
from,
books?
Yeah, anything. Any robot, any sci-fi robot.
Oh,
I always
robot
like the one from Lost in Space. Danger.
Dr. Smith is awesome me.
Danger.
He didn't really blow smoke, but
he probably did smoke at times.
I think his ears and stuff.
Probably.
what was his name again? Robbie the Robot?
Who, from Lost in Space?
Yeah.
I don't remember. Okay.
That was a creepy show.
That was a weird show. The movie they did in the 90s was ridiculous.
Yeah.
But I really enjoy it. I like a lot of those movies that came out in the 90s.
Yeah.
I thought they were ballsy.
Stupid.
And they just went for it, man. It's like they took chances that Hollywood doesn't take anymore, but because the 90s happened. Mm-hmm. But then they'll make a fucking awful movie like fucking Ghostbusters or reboot something just fucking terrible.
Yeah, has that stuff come out yet?
The Ghostbusters? It's coming out in July, man. It's coming out in July. It's fucking garbage.
Have you seen clips?
Dude, have you watched the trailer? I'll show you the trailer when we're done doing this. It's going to blow you away at how garbage this
really?
Movie is. Oh,
now, do you know the entire cast? I know there's some people I like.
Yeah. It's all SNL cast. I don't know the chick's names outside of Melissa McCarthy, honestly.
I think she's funny sometimes.
She's okay, she's being overused like Chris Farley. Oh, yeah. She's not dying quick enough like Chris Farley. Like, that's kind of her problem. But she actually does a lot of good. She's
her twinkies aren't waste.
No, they're not. They're definitely not. Alright, so fuck it, we're gonna move on.
Okay.
Because...
We can say the F word?
Yeah, you're allowed to cuss in this.
I'm trying to cuss less.
Well, I have an explicit E by the podcast. Like, I got approved, and I'm allowed to be explicit as fuck. Because why would I not be?
F word.
Fucking all day.
I'm gonna fart.
Alright, so something I really would like to talk to you about, because you crushed all... Alright, so... One of my favorite stories in comic books of all time is Preacher. And they're getting ready to make this into, I believe, is AMC that does Walking Dead and all that?
I believe you're correct.
I think it's AMC. Whoever does Breaking Bad, Walking Dead, all that. They're getting ready to do Preacher. And it's produced, and I don't know if Seth Rogen wrote it, but it's basically headed by Seth Rogen, who originally, when announced this project, so excited, said, he's like, Preacher is one of my favorite comic books ever. I think it's the greatest. I can't wait to do this as close to the story as I can. And, oh, it's going to be the best thing because I love the story and it's going to be exact. And, of course, you know it's not going to be exact, which is okay, but you do expect it to be super close. And so now, here's the kicker about it. All right. So what would you... Okay. How would you describe Preacher?
The comic.
Like the actual comic, story. Yeah.
It's a bizarre supernatural love story with all kinds of weird...
Religious. Basically everything line...
Religious everything. And...
Or biblical would be the proper term.
It's
Well, yeah, it takes from a lot of religions. Like, it's mainly the Christian religion.
Really interesting. It's an interesting read.
Yeah.
I liked it.
And it's very vulgar, very crude, very... Obscure. Just,
would you say emotion invoking? If you really read it, it really does.
And it's
emotions.
A really
it's really
twisted and dark story, man. It kind of makes you question your humanity and just our purpose. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like it's very crazy. And
there were times I read it and felt really happy. There were times I read it and
it
felt
just
sad.
Drops you, man. What did you think of Arspace's story, man?
Oh, it just hurt.
Now, can you see his story translating into an AMC show?
I don't want to see that.
I know.
I barely could look at those panels.
I know. Now, when you read his. Did you mouth it or say it out loud?
I just skipped over it.
If you actually read it, make out what he's saying. Yeah. If you hum it out, you're like, oh, shit.
Okay.
Like,
within context and what the panel has.
It's pretty amazing how they wrote out Arspace. But it's I can't see him translating into this show. The guy that's playing Preacher, he played, I don't know if you've watched any of the new Marvel movies, but he played in the Captain America movie, Howard Stark. And he also played Howard Stark on the Agent Carter show.
So Howard Stark, circa
Tony Stark's
1940.
Dog. Yeah, during the war.
Oh,
young,
43.
Young Howard Stark during the war is rolling with Captain America. And so the guy that plays
44.
Him. Yeah, he's really good. Did you watch a movie called Abraham Lincoln Vampire Hunter?
Yes, but Abraham Lincoln Zombie Killer is better.
Well, you know the guy that
the
played...
The movie was better.
Well, you know the guy that played his buddy... That taught Abraham, the vampire that trained Abraham Lincoln to be the vampire killer. That's who played Howard Stark, and that's who's playing the preacher.
Okay.
He's playing the priest. Playing.
Is he an Englishman or is he?
I don't actually know what
is he American.
I think he's American, but he also could be English. I have no idea. But I like who they got to play.
Yeah, but then if you look at, I don't know.
He's gonna have an American. He's gonna have a Texan accent.
Yeah,
regardless of. Where if he's British or you English or
what?
American.
But indicative of wasn't he from like the what East Texas where the swamps were and stuff?
He was. Was he even?
Isn't that East Texas?
Yeah, I think. But yeah. So anyway, I mean, it's got a good
West
cast.
Texas would be more desert, right? And
yeah, I don't know. I don't know my Texas.
Anyway, yeah,
Texas probably doesn't like
there's
us.
Gators in smaller parts of Texas.
Is
there? I think on the Gulf side, you know, on the swamp. Because, you know, it goes up and there's a swampy edge to it. I think there are four distinct climates in this state of Texas. It's so big. I'm not kidding.
I don't know.
Is there at least three different time zones?
No.
Oh, yeah.
It's at least in this two, man.
I bet it's three at least.
That would be crazy. Okay, while you're looking that up. All right. So, basically, there's a show on the WB called Supernatural, and it's a chick flick type horror show. I don't know how to really explain it, but it had a lot of potential, and they took a lot from Preacher in the story, is how I feel. And it's a Monster of the Week type thing. Like, it's like your X-Files and things like that, where you get a different monster.
Supernatural with those two guys?
Sammy.
Old car?
Yeah.
And aren't they, like, wearing tight t-shirts all the time,
dude.
And taking off the
and
shirt,
that's,
sweating?
And that's what I'm afraid. They already have taken so much from Preacher that, ironically, as bad of a show as it is, it's an original adaptation.
It started as a TV show.
Yeah.
Or it was a comic book.
No. It started as a TV show on the WB. And it was a mild down Preacher, but it was a way that I feel these people took Preacher, and they're like, we can kind of write an original story around this kind of folklore and with God and like religion and all this.
Right.
And it's pretty cool, but now I'm afraid that that's what Preacher's going to be. It's just going to be a dumbed down version Monster of the Week type thing. And
most likely.
In an article, check this. This is what's...
How come I'm going to Google so slow, man? That's fine.
I don't know. You should be on the Wi-Fi.
Yeah.
You might just...
I am on the Wi-Fi.
Who knows, man? You can never trust it. But, okay, so in an article, Seth Rogen recently said, we didn't want to do the comic story. We wanted to do something fun for everyone, not just sick humor and violence.
This is contrary to what he said initially.
Exactly. And so, I know you've also read Transmetropolitan, but this led me to a funny thing. I was talking to my bro, Sway.
Oh, this is a good... Good
quote. And he's like, so apparently the way that Seth Rogen got this made, if I wanted to make Transmetropolitan into a series, this is how he was like, I'll pitch it. He's like, I'm going to make Transmetropolitan into a TV show, but we are making it political, and Spider is a little rough, so we're going for a more Ryan Reynolds type. Also, the future is hard to shoot, so it will be in present day. Apparently, that's what his pitch needs to be. To get what Seth Rogen is doing to Preacher. Then he followed up with, also, does Batman need to fight crime? Or could he be a lawyer? So I feel that right there sums up the entire...
I agree.
And that's exactly what I feel they're doing with Preacher. And I don't understand why. And it's like, I've always
said... He parodied all the specific...
Yeah, man. And so I feel...
Contradictions.
It's pretty obnoxious that they would do this. I've always said, and I feel the only way Preacher could ever work was as a 90s HBO series. You know what I mean? Like, the whole thing screams the 90s, and if the HBO had done it in the 90s, I really feel that's the only possible way Preacher could have been done, and done extremely well. And it's like, now it's just going to be a joke, and I even saw, I was on Periscope, or I was on Twitter, and I follow DC Comics on Twitter, and they did a live Periscope of unveiling new comics that they're about to release within the next month or couple months or so, and one of them is Preacher, and so they're completely redoing it.
Why would you want to ruin something that was perfect to begin with?
And, you know, I'm afraid that they're really going to mold Preacher to fit this show and not actually just redo Preacher and try to do it better with better art. Because, I don't know, and can you imagine what the Saint of Killers would even be like in the show?
Hey, everybody!
That's what... Dude, it's like the man that fucking... And this is a spoiler alert. I don't give a shit if you've read it. This has been out since the 90s, and I hope it ruins the show for you if you're one of the fools that like it. But the Saint of Killers kills the devil. Whenever he dies, hell freezes over, and he walks in and goes, pep! And shoots the devil in the forehead. And so the devil's been dead since, what, the cowboy days? Yeah. So, what was that? Would that be the 1800s?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So,
post-Civil War 1800s.
Yeah. And God is the villain of this whole series. In fact, the whole idea is about a demon and an angel making a baby, and it's an abomination that should never exist. And this voice screams out and takes over this pastor in Texas who's down on his faith and doesn't care anymore, takes his body over, gives him the word of God that whatever he says, people have to do. And he goes on a mission to find God and figure out why everything's this way and why God doesn't care. And it's the craziest story. He goes down the fucking rabbit hole. Like, it is unbelievable, and it is such a good story. And in this, God is probably going to be a prisoner or something, or it's going to be something so lame that they're not going to make God the villain. And the minute you don't make God the villain in this, you've defeated the entire idea of the story of Preacher. And that's very upsetting. That's very upsetting.
It's an interesting study in humanity.
It is.
It really is.
So
it's a good book. I'm glad you finally made me read it.
Oh my god!
And then you gave me
volumes. I gave him the entire. I think I gave you the first two in the beginning.
Two books. I read it now.
Yeah, and so then you're like, but I also gave him the first like 2 to 3 books of Transmetropolitan, and he read them both in one night. That's like 6 books, 6 volumes. And he's like, is there more to this? I'm like, yeah. He's like, just bring it all to me. I brought him every single volume of both Transmet and Preacher, and he had them both read in one night. And he just came back fucking stoked. Did you read, you know how, I know you read the extra panels in them and all. Did you read, did you read where Patrick Stewart, Captain Picard himself, he was trying to push for a Transmetropolitan movie where
he
would
play Spider-Jerusalem. That would be interesting.
Oh, man, could you imagine?
He can do anything. I believe he's a versatile actor, so.
He's the man.
Yeah, like, and he was a fan of the book?
Oh, he loves it.
So, obviously, he knows, I bet he has a really interesting interpretation of the character. What he should be like.
Exactly. Could you really imagine what he would do?
What did he used to come to me by, Filthy Servants?
Yeah, my Filthy Servants. I always like the Bow Disruptor.
Oh yeah, that was a nasty one. Did it ever really?
He took down Smiley. Smiley was the devil.
So, do you think Patrick Stewart would affect a colonial accent, affect an American accent? Because it wasn't Spider Jerusalem in New York, and
so actually, at the point in time, nobody even knew what the year date was anymore. They thought Hitler was a pop star. History is obscured. Voices. So he wouldn't have American or British. It wouldn't matter what the fuck he had. He was of no ethnic background anymore.
I understand what you're saying. But at the same time, so who knows what the future sounds like is what you're saying.
But Patrick Stewart, you can do it as a British. I think Patrick Stewart, but I think Patrick Stewart's proved he can do any accent.
Oh, I agree. But I would.
He would have. I think
he would
do an American.
Affect an American.
Yeah, and I think American he would.
Accent. And whatever interpretation you want to do, but
that's true. But
make it some kind of American. If he wants to be extreme,
you think that would have translated into a good movie or show?
Movie with Patrick Stewart and consistency on, and maybe like distinction among the different accents, but. Consistency on that. I don't want one person talking their nostril. I don't know.
Or maybe you don't want to see Schwarzenegger play in Spider Jerusalem.
Mm-hmm.
By the way, man, I really got to say again, I'm so upset you didn't bring Snoozledorf. I've been waiting for this beer for so long, and you just couldn't get it. But I guess you got to get it in
Dorf, Germany. It's excellent.
Well, I thought Germany? I thought it might have been from the Czech. I guess we don't really know. I guess it would be a German brew. Maybe Austrian. Maybe who knows?
Yeah, who knows? I have to look it up.
Yeah,
well, when I bring the bottle over, we'll look.
Yeah, man, we'll figure out.
Can this. Or it's good in any.
I can't.
Vessel.
I can't wait to get
any,
down
any sort of vessel.
In any kind
bottle,
of vessel. Yeah. Yeah, I love the word vessel.
Give me your brother.
Okay, so I'm really. Let me see what our time is so far. Oh, we've gone 49 minutes.
Already?
We're doing. Yeah, this has already been 40. Yeah, dude. You're holding it down, man. I really appreciate this so much.
I hope I am. I'm.
And then I'll tell you, man, once Andy, like, it sucks. He not only was he sick and had a fever, he actually had to work tonight, which is a bummer. But he's a cab driver, but he's working at like a hotspot type place type thing. Get some extra hours. So he actually had to do that tonight, too, the poor bastard. But hopefully next time you come on, the three of us can be on. And really, we'll even do
good.
an even longer...
I won't step on anyone's toes.
Oh, you're not. But it's like, we can do a really, like, the three of us here to really talk some shit. It would be really fun. And we could even do a longer episode. Because I really appreciate you doing this and taking the time to come on here. But I would also, I would like to have you again. I would really like to have you again.
I would enjoy that.
Okay. So, like, okay, I think we both decided that Preacher shouldn't happen. It's just a bag of dicks, especially compared to how great of a story it is.
Yeah, there are other problems I have with it, too. But, yeah, what I read about it.
Well, tell me some of your problems.
Well, just the, I want to see all ethnic groups in my shows and around me, and I've always grown up in a multicultural environment. I enjoy that. But don't cast people that are opposite of the characters in the book. You know, Tulip was a blonde-haired, blue-eyed woman. I want to see a blonde-haired, blue-eyed woman playing her. That's
all.
Like
if you're gonna
if she were a black character, an African-American character, I would want to see... I don't want a white person to play her. I want an African-American to play her.
It's, if you're going to get an Irishman to play Cassidy the Vampire...
Yeah, why don't you just make him Canadian?
Why don't you make him... Yeah. Fucking attacking people, eh? Hey. Yeah. Oh, my God. The hoser. Oh, but yeah, that's... And that's...
I was in Montreal once and got puked.
And I agree with you. I think there comes a point that it's like, we were talking about this earlier, that it's like when, it's like with Johnny Storm, and here's where you just can't win. It's like you can't take, like, when they redid the Fantastic Four, everybody was mad that Johnny Storm was black, which,
right.
Yeah, man, it's like you got a brother and sister character. It's like, why?
Is he still the brother?
They were still brother and sister. She was adopted into a black family.
Interesting.
Yeah, so they did tweak it, which is okay, but at the same time, you're taking a brother and a sister character. It's like, make them both black if you're going to do it.
Yeah.
You know, go ahead and go full-blown and make them both black.
Create a new great superhero team that's all black. I'm fine with that, too.
Marvel, Fox just doesn't have properties, and they did this. But here's the sad part. You can't make Mr. Fantastic black. It's like, you can, but people of the comic book, if you don't have a nerdy white dude that's going to get white in his hair and just be this, they're not going to be happy. Well, no.
Urkel as Mr. Fantastic.
No. Could you imagine his lanky ass, like, stretching?
Exactly.
Yeah. But no, it's like people wouldn't be happy with that, because that's a major, 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 major character. But then you also can't take Ben Grimm, who's going to turn into this giant rock monster. You can't make him a black guy, so then the rest of the movie, when he gets his powers, it's just this black CGI rock. Like, people would lose it. They're like, oh yeah, make the one character you're going to flip his ethnicity, just becomes a CGI rock monster.
But orange is neutral.
Is it? Yeah. Well, he's not in the new movie. He wasn't orange. He was actual, like, rock and dirt rock color and shit like that. He wasn't just this orange monster. Like, he, and it was all dark. It was terrible. Though. But it's okay to do that.
Traditionally, the thing is orange.
Yeah.
And so you could be any color. Dude, human. Because Ben Grimm is white. He is not
true,
orange.
True, but
or
the idea of making
pink,
the character...
Lighter pink, right? Whatever the color we are.
But yeah, but that's the thing. It's like, you can't take a character you're going to make CGI for the second half of the movie. You can't make that the black dude, and then it's like, oh, okay, way to remove the African-American actor. You know what I mean? It's like, way to be a dick about it.
Yeah.
So it's just kind of this moment you're caught in. But it's like you said, it's like, why can't we just create new stories? It's like clearly the Incredibles were able to do a mock-type Fantastic Four superhero thing with creating new characters and fitting all these characters. It's like, just leave the old shit alone. Take these stories and adapt them. I mean, if you can take Yojimbo and make it into Fistful of Dollars or into The Last Man Standing and shit like that. And so you can take this story and make it your own thing without having to steal these exact characters.
Like,
if Fox has the rights to Fantastic Four, use your rights to Fantastic Four, but just completely make a new story that it's not like the people that own the Fantastic Four get to sue you for making a Fantastic Four movie without those characters' names. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, fit it that way. Do something completely original and rock it out. And I understand that people want to see them, but, I mean, fuck it.
Yeah, I'd just rather see whole new characters.
Whatever
color.
Here's
I don't care, but just the original, I don't know, translation.
So, man, it's like when you read and you see it, like, especially a character that you've had, I mean, that's a character since the fucking 60s right there. You know what I mean? You have a character that's been solidified through so much and so much lore and all this, and then you're just like, but once again, I guess, who gives a shit? But at the same time, if you're going to make this story and want to adapt it on the screen, make the story and adapt it. Like, don't just change stupid shit.
I agree, but it's all about, you know, it just becomes a product.
It's all, yeah, man. Yeah.
Even though it failed, I mean, they still made money, right? Probably.
No, we lost money. The night of the premiere, and we talked about this on the last podcast, the night of the premiere, the guy that directed it, Trank or whatever the fuck this dude's name is, he was tweeting and just shitting on this movie so hard, dude.
The guy that directed it?
Yeah, man. He immediately shit on a premiere night. Why he was at it. Yeah, give me another one, please. Thank you. That bag's getting light.
You're welcome.
Cool. All right. I like that one. Now, I think, once again, the time now is 55 minutes.
Can we pause?
Or no? Would you?
I'm going to take a squirt.
Yeah.
Okay.
We're good. I'll pause it.
Okay.
I'm going to cut this audio file. So, we're coming back. We had to take a quick minute. We decided to take a piss. We've been drinking all night, alright? I'm just gonna go ahead and stress that. It's like we've been drinking.
Just beer.
It's just beer, but we've been drinking. And, we went and upgraded to some nice-ass glasses, and we're gonna finish this podcast out in style.
Salute.
Yeah! But, We just had to take a quick minute. We're coming back. I just want to say again, thank you if you're still listening. This is Park and Lock Podcast. Andy's sick for the night. And so,
Park and Lock Podcast.
Park and Lock! But yeah.
Okay.
But yeah, I really, like I said, if you're listening, I really appreciate it. I hope you enjoy. Send us some feedback, any questions. It's Scotty's our first, I know Andy's not here, but he's our first guest and just sub.
Yes.
Sub in.
I'm subbing
so.
Out. I'm subbing out. Andy, this is Andy's gig. I'm my buns are keeping this seat warm for Andy.
But no, hopefully, if any of you would like to be on our podcast sometime, why don't you come on down? We would love to have you. Work it out. Hit us up. It's fun. It's a good time. Regardless of what you know, it's a good time. If you have questions that you'd like to just hear debated or just bullshitted, go ahead and send them in. Yeah. So, okay, but we're going to hop back in this. I think this is going to end up being our final question with how long it's going to take, because I kind of shot this to you earlier, and you were ready for it, but the way I'm going to ask this question first is, it's a classic question. What do you like more, Star Wars or Star Trek?
Let's see.
There's a lot, I think there's
a
lot more.
That's Iron Giant. That's
I think there's... There's a lot of Star Trek around, but I think
there's
a lot of wars.
I'd have to say.
Oh!
Star Trek.
All right. And I got to agree, it's a no-brainer that Star Trek is a far superior sci-fi.
It's about us.
Yeah, it is.
It's about us.
Earth, man. It's about us, man. It's the greatest thing ever written. So, fuck the question of what's better. It's like, clearly, it's Trek. So, what my question is...
Live long and prosper.
What is your favorite Star Trek series?
Oh, I love them all. I love them all. The original will always be near and dear to my heart.
It's like, you can't...
First time I watched it was on a black and white TV about this big. Kids, I know you don't know what that is. You had a dial. You had a golden... And I was so young that I was sucking my thumb again in calluses. And my parents said, if you don't suck your thumb, you can watch Star Trek. And I said, okay. That's how I quit sucking my thumb.
Thumb sucker over here. So, what is your favorite then? You're too old to be doing this, Scotty.
Deep Space Nine.
You don't have the power. Oh, Deep Space Nine. DS9 is your favorite.
Why?
Yeah. Well, first, I'm going to go ahead and say... I knew this was also a no-brainer when I made this question, but I like reaffirming how I feel. And like you said, you cannot fuck with Star Trek, the original series. It is gold.
Or TOS, as they say.
TOS.
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 When you see like Star Trek, you get a product.
Yeah.
You know, whether what
series. Or it would be DS9 or TNG.
TOS is the original series.
STV.
Yeah.
But yeah, so TOS is fantastic. You cannot. It's beautiful. It's everything.
I love it.
It's human.
Yes,
it's so human.
It.
But I agree with you. I think Deep Space Nine is the most like Next Generation. The cast and the story is awesome, and it's just like the original.
It.
You don't
have
to follow
all. I love
all, but,
Enterprise.
But when you Enterprise isn't that bad. But when you when you watch DS9, it's like from episode 1 to the end, it's one full story. It is fantastic. That is, the war that they have in it is fucking beautiful. Like, just the story of working with the Klingons in this war.
Oh, no, when will you come back to the Dominion?
Yes, the fucking, like, everything about it, it was so Star Trek, and it took place on a battle station. You know, like, what, it's like it wasn't cruising the galaxy in a starship. It was a battle station and a wormhole.
Captain of African descent.
Yeah.
Andrew Brooks.
The religious aspect of it with the Kais and all that. Everything about it was wild.
It was interesting because the human future seems to be devoid of religion. And you have the mythos throughout races. But to add that for the Bajorans to be deep religious people.
Oh, man.
It was an interesting contrast to the atheistic kind of humans.
Yeah, we've evolved past this.
Yeah.
But also...
And to make Captain Sisko, Avery Brooks, a god.
Yeah. You're gonna get spoilers, but yeah. You've had over what 20? Yeah, oh, you have almost 30 years to catch up to this, man. So that's how we feel. But
the third series, the first one after
Next Generation.
The
whole the story of Sisko, the main captain, his whole. The him being the writer and not showing the picture because of his skin color and him screaming, this universe is real, tying it into like a 1920s.
It was created in the 50s.
Yeah. But okay, yeah, so a 1950s newspaper writer created this whole world and it's in his head. And it's.
Yeah.
And that's a crazy story arc to throw into it and really play it to the end.
His name was Benny.
Benny.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, like that shit was fantastic.
It was at the Sci-Fi magazine that parodied DC Fontana, if you know who Dorothy Fontana is. Are you familiar with her?
Is she?
She wrote some of the original Star Trek episodes on.
Like TOS
style. Original series, and then she co-wrote the plot for Encounter at Farpoint. There's a whole story of that. The first Deus, Next Generation, rather.
Is that the one with Q and all?
Yeah, no. The first one.
Wait, the main episode.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
She was a script consultant on the entire Next Generation series. But
okay.
Dorothy Fontana, and she used DC, so people wouldn't know she was a woman necessarily. She wrote westerns and
really
and different things. And that was the character that, Nana Visitor played Kira.
Wait, who?
Nana Visitor is the actor's name.
What is her name?
Her really name, last name is really Visitor.
But what's her name?
Nana. I think. N-A-N-A.
Okay.
Visitor, I believe, is her name. Correct me if I'm wrong. But in that episode you're talking about where they flip-flopped in the 50s, she
was the writer.
Was Casey something or other to parody. And they don't show her. Montana.
But they also don't show her picture in that paper.
Because remember they said, you don't show up Benny and you don't show up to the woman.
Yeah. So what's the twofers, both women and
they all wanted. And it was interesting with Bashir, I thought, because he played a more accepted
European. Not Visitor.
Yeah, am I right?
Yeah, that's.
Yeah.
Oh, there's my man Dennis Hopper. Oh, I know her.
Yeah.
Oh.
Kira.
No way.
Not a Visitor. Yeah.
Damn. Yeah. Dude, what was she in with Dennis Hopper? Demo reel. I love Dennis Hopper.
Know.
Frank Booth is my dude. All right.
Okay.
Not a Visitor. No.
You didn't ask me why I love Deep Space Nine.
But why?
Well, there's a lot of reasons, but one of them, the main one, is more aliens per scene than any Star Trek.
It's very true.
There's aliens all over the damn place. Which
but
I
it was
think
it was
be.
Like the Ellis Island of alien
but
shit.
It was awesome.
It was like a refugee joint too.
Yeah,
so.
But it was cool.
The Ferengi, the Ferengi bar is a fantastic.
Yeah, different
set.
Races owning different things.
Everything.
And the interaction of all these different races. It was a multicultural station.
One of my
maybe.
Favorite characters is the Grand Nagus.
I love the Grand Nagus. The Grand Nagus.
What is his name? Wallace Scott.
Oh
no, yeah,
actor.
Right.
The
Alan Scott, I believe he played the Pavilion and the Princess Bride.
Yeah. May I have another peanut?
Yes.
No! Yeah, what is that guy's name?
No, it was No More Running and I Mean It. No
may
More Running.
Another, yeah,
may
I have
another
peanut?
Have another peanut? Oh my god. I'm gonna just. Oh, but yeah.
Wallace Scott, look it up. I think that's his name.
Oh my god, that's not how you spell Princess. The autocorrect and the drunkness is not. Is not helping.
I would do it on mine, but he's got a Wi-Fi access beyond.
Yeah,
me,
I don't know
apparently.
Why the fuck yours isn't working.
Yeah.
The actor's name was Wallace Shawn.
Wallace Shawn.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
Vegas. Wallace Shawn, you idiot. What was the name of his servant? Pirate servant.
Oh.
Remember his pirate man servant?
Yeah.
What was his name?
I don't remember.
And when was the only time he ever talked in the series?
In what?
Deep Space Nine. His
he always talked.
First.
No, there was one of secrecy. He was in. The Nagus?
The band servant.
Oh.
He did not talk. They were Pyrian servants were sworn to.
What are you doing? Sit your ass down,
I'm
boy.
I'm putting it this way. Pyrian servants are sworn to silence.
Yeah, I don't
only
fucking remember.
To their masters.
What
was the
it?
Only time he talked?
I don't know. When? Whenever.
It was a prophet encounter with Sisko when he went to the, you know, when he... Went to the commune with the prophets.
Yeah.
And it would be people he knew talking, you know, through them.
Okay.
You know, like images of, that's how they knew how to project themselves.
Okay.
Well, it was him. It was the manservant of the Nagus. And he said something. I believe his name is really Tiny Ron, and he was a basketball player.
Do you know what he said, though?
He was just saying something like, you know, how... They spoke in riddles.
Yeah, that's true.
You know, he just said riddle stuff to him.
What do you call it? I really enjoy Deep Space Nine. I really, really, really enjoy the story of the Ferengi women and how women wearing clothes is like, oh, holy shit. Like,
but then his mom helped change that.
Yeah.
But she did it, the Grand Nagus.
The whole social stance on it all is fucking hilarious. I love it. But, all right. So, and this is, like I said, I know earlier I asked you, when I asked you this question, you were like, oh, do you want to hear it now?
Oh, and I think when I know it's coming.
We were rolling in the car, and you're like, I've been saying this for years, and this is what it needs to be. And I don't actually have an answer to this question, so I'm going to hold off and think a minute.
And the question is?
Hold on. But like I said, I told Scotty, I was like, I don't want to hear it until this podcast because I feel I could be really excited and might get partial chub by what he might tell me. Boom. But the new question is, I want to say this too, man. I don't know how you feel about it. All right. So you know the couple episodes over the years they've done of Terran, the Terran Empire? Which is
basically the Mirror Mirror Universe.
Mirror
Mirror Universe.
Okay, so
I didn't like Deep Space Nine as much. They overdid it.
They did.
They went there too many times.
But, exactly. But, I like that this alternate Nazi futuristic Klingon type universe exists for us. That it's like, I've always would like to see a series through any generation.
Based on that Empire.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen the Enterprise episodes?
Yeah, those were awesome.
Those were the best ever of the universe.
Those were fantastic. Enterprise may not be the best Star Trek, but that is fantastic episodes, man.
You know what the best parts of it was? Huh. I mean, the story, the plot, everything was great.
Yeah, dude.
But we didn't have to hear the theme song. Because remember they had the dark... and militaristic music.
Opening. Dude, I forgot how terrible that opening song is. Oh my god. Okay, so yeah, you're absolutely right. That's even better.
I got strength of the high.
Oh my god. You know, I don't want to hear
it. It was written by him, but you know originally recorded that. I believe it was Rod Stewart.
Really?
That's the version of that.
That's,
I got strength.
I wouldn't even want to hear Rod Stewart fucking talk about this. So once again, I haven't even said the fucking question.
Straight to the high.
I'm gonna knock him the fuck out, people. But I'm not, because he's being kind enough to fill in for Andy, and you can't be pissed. I'm right! Here we go. Alright, so, what my question is, if they were to continue and pull Star Wars, if they were to pull Star Wars back on TV, no. Alright, so, if they were to start... Oh, shit.
What?
The camera died. He won't stop. He says it's the Ron Stewart version, but it doesn't make it better. Just turn it off. No. Alright. Okay, so the camera died. I thought
the mod doing the original version. I mean, it's brilliant, Matt. It's nothing like the opening.
You close your phone. You shut your mouth.
All right.
Either way, I told you we've been drinking. I thought I had enough battery to do this. So apparently we are going over. So fuck it, we're hopping. I swear to Jesus.
I got faith.
I swear to God.
Faith in the high.
All right, so here we go. We're going to continue the question, because I actually want to hear what Scott, I don't care how long this goes over. I actually want to hear you have to say. So,
please.
What the question is if they pick Star Trek back up and put it on TV, where should it take place? What should the story be? And I know you got it. So
thanks for asking.
I'm going to probably just not even give a fuck about what I could say because I want to hear what you have to say.
You can say what you have to say after.
All right.
You give me the floor.
I'm gonna take a cigarette.
Okay, please. Take what you want. Take from the new pack,
Is this new?
Yeah, that's a new pack. All right. That I just opened. Fresh.
All right. Now go ahead.
Star Trek. Okay. My friend. Chris and I came up with this idea. You call it Star Trek Anomaly, and you have different story arcs from different time periods. You explore Deep Space Nine with a new crew after everybody's left and the end of, you know, that. You go into things what Riker and Troy are doing on the Titan. You go through what, you know, they in the life of what's Janeway doing now? Have a separate point you can go through. They call it Star Trek Anomaly, so
well,
you have the freedom to go to any era.
I gotta tell you,
what do you think?
In the Star Trek universe, which movie is it that Picard talks to Janeway and she's an old ass bitch?
Oh, in the last one, because they got back.
Or that's
back.
The last episode?
Yeah, she wasn't old. She was just Admiral Janeway at that
I thought
point.
She was in a movie, though.
She was
older.
On a view screen. Yeah.
But she was older looking, right? So you're talking about before that.
It was a year after the series ended or something.
But are you talking about following new people then?
I'm talking about doing old people.
But
continuity.
So the people that looked, I think the guy that plays Sisko is too far out anymore.
Well, no. He's a god now. He's not even in our real planet.
Oh, that's very true.
You don't have to use him. You know, you see what maybe Nana Visitor, maybe Kira is on the edge of retirement. Maybe, you know, Nog is visiting with his ship.
So Nog grown up and all.
Well, Nog was already, by the end of that series, he was
but
on...
But he wasn't a full man.
No, he was assigned to Deep Space Nine, and he was a lieutenant, he was a lieutenant.
Did he roll with Chief?
No, his O'Brien. Dad did. His dad, more so. Because remember, his dad
Who
was
Who trained him through the academy and all when he joined?
Well, he got Sisko to sponsor him.
That's true. And then
he went in and did it. He was a very intelligent individual. It's just, you know, Frankie's society, he wasn't being taught the things he needed to be taught. Remember,
okay,
there was
one
episode that brings tears to your eyes because Sisko thinks Nog's a bad influence on Jake. And he goes down and he realizes he's going to bust them and say, you shouldn't be hanging out with him. And he's teaching him how to read.
Damn.
Yeah. Jake is teaching Nog how to read. Yeah.
Okay, well, yeah, I like that.
So he had that human influence.
So you would want your series to...
Normally.
Essentially just jump through time.
Yeah, you can see what Captain Picard's doing in a certain period of time. You can even do a thing where it's in a certain time period, like, you know, say it's parallel to an original episode. And
like they did the Tribble episode in DS9.
Not necessarily that, but the same time period that, you know, they refer to things, and maybe you get a close look at the reference on, you know, the people who were... You know, behind the scenes in the Borg War.
So other stories surrounding certain stories, too.
Yeah, okay. Stuff like that you could do. And even new stuff. It's the Star Trek universe. It's so wide open.
Okay, so you wouldn't want to see...
Story arcs. Maybe a week story arc, 2 weeks.
Well, okay, so...
And then maybe some would be one episode, one would be three episodes.
I do like that, but I think I would want to see it take place maybe another couple hundred years. See where the Federation of Planets and...
Yeah, but we could do that.
Well, actually, what's it called? Is it the
United Federation of Planets?
Is it?
UFP. Yeah.
What's it called in Invincible? The Coalition of Planets.
Coalition of Planets,
okay.
Yeah.
I just wanted to make sure I wasn't going to be quoted.
Yeah,
fucking
Star
Invincible.
Trek is... Yeah.
Yeah. All right, so...
UFP.
So you wouldn't rather just see one story take place maybe way into
no,
the future
No, I want them
all
to
this.
explore the...
The entire universe.
Aftermath
of
different series.
Okay.
And at the same time, you know, for the continuity, at the same time, you know, new stuff too.
Yeah.
And stuff that's parallel to, you know, stuff that fits in canon.
Okay.
You know,
that would be really
Star
cool.
Star Trek Anomaly, you know, because you're going all over the place.
I think
two Trekkies, if there are enough of us, to keep it afloat. But...
Well, what do you think, what would you think of for a story of it more be like, is it Section 13?
Yeah.
Imagine a Section 13 type people, but like Section 43. Something like that, and more like follow maybe 2 to 3 characters that end up time hopping through these situations. Rather, so you can follow,
we can do
so
that.
You
we
can see the future
be,
of the Federation, but also you can have two characters that have to relive these time periods.
Well, it
could
be
like,
a history project.
Yeah, like what if the quantum time thing has been thrown off and it's too like
if you wanted
time
that,
travelers
if you
going
wanted
through
that
keeping,
as in there, There are plenty of vehicles you could use for the narration.
That's true.
To link it together. That's, I know what you're true. Saying.
But yeah.
I would make it more like a, you know, watching through a view screen or on a holodeck type thing.
Oh.
If these people are doing the history and you could pause at that point.
That would be crazy.
But I wouldn't give too much about where they are and then you can make that a thing.
Yeah. Eventually. But would you want to see what the future of the Federation has in store?
Yeah, but remember, all this is, you know, it's future.
What if
the future is always speculative.
Sure.
Any little thing can change the future.
Now, if we could go into the future of the Federation, what is something you would like to see? What would you think after the events of? Because also you got to think that the Star Trek Next Generation movies happen after the series, outside of the very first movie. All the rest of them happen after everything has taken place through the actual TV show. And that's a thing with the
only
movies.
Only the last
yeah.
one.
No, they all do, don't they?
No, only the last one.
No, because the series was done by the time they were doing those movies. Because by the time the Borg movie came out, the series had been over. So it's like those movies are
maybe,
supposed to
maybe
take...
Maybe a couple.
The,
okay,
but yeah,
right.
So over half of those movies are supposed to take
no,
place
afterwards. I think you're correct.
But what?
Yeah.
But still, what would you? What do you think the Federation would be up to, even, say, 80 fucking years into the future of the very last events of Star Trek Voyager or TNG, whatever
well,
goes
see,
further.
That's the thing. You know, you're talking about... See, what you truly want to see is, like...
It's not what I truly want to
peace
see.
Peace and harmony.
No. What could be
that
the
doesn't
threat?
Sell things.
But what could be the threat at
that's
that
you,
point?
Yeah.
What could the Federation be dealing with, like... Oh, we're not able to truly provide things for free because...
I'd like to see, like, tiny little stories where it's, like, any threat is really just...
True.
We're fine, you know, and...
I've heard of a story point where...
We're not going conquering. If you want to join us, come see us.
Well, I think there's a fan-made thing somewhere online or something of
the
lines of,
like... Well, there's one where Tupac is the head of area section...
I'm not going to believe that, and I don't know what that is, but...
Oh, it's so good. It's called Renegades. You need to watch it. And Chekhov is, like, 150 years old, and he's like, you know, this old admiral, and it's pretty neat.
It's
and
a real thing? Like, are you not fucking with
no,
me?
No, I'm not messing with you. It's on YouTube.
What's it called?
Renegades. Star Trek Renegades.
If you haven't seen this, I haven't seen it, and you like
and,
Trek, look it up. Is it really Tupac?
Or Boca, yeah.
Or is it a parody? Don't lie to me
or
right
not
now.
Tuvok.
I'm Tuvok. Yeah. You fucking... I enjoy calling Tuvok Tupac, but that was fucking fantastic.
Because
could you imagine seeing Tupac in a fucking Trek shit? Wow. Tuvok, people. He's from
you
Star Trek.
You thought I was dead back then? I'm back here.
In
Section 41. Peace.
Okay, yeah, I do know what you're talking about. Yes. Oh, my God.
And, like, what's his name's in it? The, of course, 7 of 9 was the most...
was she a human?
Notoriously famous Borg that we rescued, but...
True.
What was it? Egypt. Egypt's in it.
Was she the kid?
Remember Egypt? No, it was the dude. Remember he was like a teenager? He had a little thing over his eye.
Yeah, okay, the Borg kid.
Egypt.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay. That's what's up.
Egypt's in it, and yeah.
That's what's up. Really... I have nothing but respect for people that love Trek. It's like, I didn't get into it until probably, I don't even know.
Live long.
And prosper. And you know, I had a man once describe that everybody hated this guy. He was kind of a dick. But I really liked him. I worked with him at a Target. And I would work with this guy, and the only things he loved in life was his wife and daughter, guns, and Star Trek. I'm not even fucking kidding. Like, this is what these are the three things this
that's
man's right. life revolves
four.
Around.
Four. Wife and daughter.
Wife and daughter, family.
Comes one. Okay,
yeah,
family.
I count that. That's like your immediate, like, three. Your family that you've made. But yeah, I guess that could be. But either way, this dude loved it. He would tell me nothing about Star Trek and why it would give him hope, and he liked it. And I was young and I would listen to this dude talk. I'm like, yeah, okay, that's cool. But I finally sat down one day to watch TOS. And it floored me. And I was like, I couldn't imagine being alive when this was on TV and seeing, like, these social issues tackled. And it's just an like the stories have always been ahead of their time, that it's not even funny. And it's a really cool thing, and I feel more people should get into it. And I really know Abrams has brought people to it, and he's revamped it. And it's not necessarily good, bad. I know you don't like them, but I do enjoy them. I'm really excited for this third one. You know, I've watched the trailer, and I fucking love it. It's like, I love what they bring to the table. Thank you. And but I feel Star Trek is such a great series, and more, and I feel people relate it too much to nerds, and it's like, it's not, it's for everybody, and it's like, it's something like we should look to. And when people in this time during this election are afraid of socialism, they should just watch Star Trek and see what it could really bring. I don't know, like, that's what really crazy. I saw a fucking meme, and this meme is so hilarious because it doesn't fucking matter. But still, it's like, Star Trek is just a fucking fantastic series. And anything that can be done, it went on TV, it only aired 2 seasons
originally. It's supposed to be a 5-year mission in 3.
But I know there are 3 seasons, but it originally aired as 2. Or did it go all 3 seasons in full? But by the 3rd season, gets wacky.
Well, the Nielsen rating thing, and they had a weird way of calculating.
But when did it go off the air? Do you know?
It aired from like 65 to 68.
Okay, so then we did not get another series until about 83?
80.
Was it 80?
Are you sure that's what TNG? No, I'm talking about the movie. Star Trek, the movie.
Well, I get we were doing the movie.
Beyond 80, but that was the next.
That's true, but when was the next Star Trek series? Because it hasn't been on TV series? For years. When did Next Generation
about
start? 85?
86, 87.
I say it started 85. Mm-mm. Yeah, dude.
Was it?
Look it up.
I'm going to. Let's see.
But 80 was when, 79, 80 was when Star Trek the movie came out, and Orson Welles did the narration. And it was just like, for people like me, as a little kid, and even my parents, it was just like so exciting to see those characters back.
1987. Then. You're right.
Spock. Kirk. Uhura. Yeah.
Now, what year did Voyager end? 2001.
Yeah.
So we had Star Trek from 1987 straight to 2001 and straight in a series. And when did Enterprise start?
About then. 2001.
2001 to 2005. Yep. So we had Star Trek straight on TV from 87 to 2005. Mm-hmm. And then we haven't had anything. And we're, over 11 years later? And it's
we need that hope.
Yeah, it's like, I really feel we deserve a Star Trek series. And I know we're getting the movies with Abrams, but we need an original Star Trek series. They're just fun Star Trek. Like, you gotta just be happy we have Trek and that somebody's brothers and asses.
Remakes bad.
Remakes suck, but we need hope and joy.
Okay, I have no artistic talent, but if I did, I would draw this cartoon bathroom and it would say J.J. Abrams bathroom on it. And the toilet paper.
The Enterprise?
Toilet paper would read Roddenberry's Dream.
Oh, yes. Don't say that.
Oh, I'm saying it. I just said it.
Golly. Okay. Well, I'm going to end the podcast here. But,
all right.
Hold on. Andy normally writes out a lot of these questions. And so, at the end of our thing, we do a segment called Marry, Fuck, and Kill.
Oh, good Lord.
You're goddamn right, man.
Oh, I hate this.
Exactly. So, since we're both Trekkies and nerds, at first I was thinking about marry, fuck, kill, and do Jesse Custer, her general, or you know the main villain guy, kind of in Preacher and Cassidy. But I'm not gonna do it Preacher related. Instead, I'm gonna make it Star Trek related.
Oh, great!
You gotta marry, fuck, or kill Captain Kirk, Spock. Well, I was going to make it Captain Kirk.
All dudes?
Well, yeah, but that's the thing. It's okay. We're going to do Captain Kirk, Spock, and Bones. I was going to do Kirk, Scotty, Bones. That might be a cooler combo. Who would you prefer as the lineup?
You'd marry Spock because you'd only have to fight him off every 7 years. you'd kill Kirk because he's a horny bastard. And I guess, you know.
You fuck Bones?
Yeah, I guess.
Why would he break bones?
Well, because he's going to die then, and he won't be able to tell too many people about it.
Why? Because he's old? Mm-hmm. Well, I guess normally...
Because I'm heterosexual.
But, so I mean, the fad is normally to kill whoever's old, so you can... Well, you would...
No, you kill Kirk as his rival.
He is a rival.
And every 7 years, you have to fight Spock or hide from him. But then
so
it's
that's
over,
who
he's
married.
So he's not going to want to fuck you. Yeah.
And plus, he has no emotion. He doesn't have to worry. It's every 7 years,
yeah,
you got to worry about taking it.
The pawn far, and then that's when you take the hell off and you like shoot him full of tranquilizer or something.
Personally, I would marry Kirk. That's my homie. He would take care of me. He's only going to rank me throughout
the
years.
Yeah,
until
he saw something else he liked better.
That's very true. That's very true.
That's why you killed him, man.
Maybe I'll take my fucking from Kirk, just because he's a player. And I'll take whatever STD gives me. I guess it would be a lot. I'd rather marry Bones, just because we could bicker for years.
Well, no, that's the thing. He's old, so he dies soon, so that's
why
you're
gonna fuck him. Alright, so I think I'll kill Kirk, because...
Like I said, it's a weird thing for your sexual orientation.
Hold on, yeah. I'm gonna kill Kirk. I'm gonna fuck Spock, because that's gonna be scary and wild.
Wow.
And I'm gonna marry Bones. That's how I'm gonna do it, because...
You get the inheritance.
Yeah.
But if you
marry Spock, he's going to outlive you by hundreds of years and just move on and never remember
isn't
you.
Isn't it a double
point.
Effort? Because, like, the person you're going to marry, don't you have to F them anyway?
Well, yeah, that's your spouse.
So you're effing two guys.
Technically,
whereas
you're fucking two guys.
I only effing one guy.
That's true.
Bones and then Spock, like I said, every 7 years you could avoid it.
You're winning at a heterosexual point of
view.
Yeah,
and no offense to any... I have utmost respect for anyone who's gay, whatever. That's your choice. I'm just not wired that way. So this... Like, if you chose three women, it'd be easier. But
that's
anyway,
not what
I mean,
you get.
That's why you're making it harder.
I know.
That's why if you had, you know, a gay person, you should, do it all female.
So check this. Just out of fucking fun and curiosity, I'm going to run you our past two Mary Fuck Kills. Bernie Sanders... Hillary Clinton, Trump.
And she'd F Hillary.
All right. But why would you not marry Hillary? At least you're going to get lady sex forever.
Oh, no. She doesn't want that.
Okay, so you're going to just fuck Hillary.
Yes.
All right, who are you going to marry?
Bernie.
Because he's going to die soon. And he can't
get
it up.
And I don't think he wants men.
He can't get it up.
I don't think he enjoys sex with men. So
probably not,
we have a platonic marriage.
He can't get it up.
He can't get it up. Yeah.
And then you would murder Trump.
But if you had to, at least you know he's circumcised, guaranteed, because he's Jewish.
All right.
So you don't have to deal with that nasty hood. And then Trump. Yeah, it's just Trump, man. Knock him off.
All right. And here's the other one. Out of the Batman, Michael Keaton, Val Kilmer, and... who did we go with? Oh, Christian Bale.
Okay.
Out of those three, who would you marry, fuck, kill?
Kill Christian Bale because he's devious.
Yes.
Fuck Val Kilmer because he's pretty, and then marry Michael Keaton because he probably wouldn't want man sex from you anyway.
But Val Kilmer,
Pittsburgh.
Would you not? He is from Pittsburgh.
Yeah, Michael Keaton. So that's he. Married.
So wait, but
I'm from near Pittsburgh.
But Val Kilmer is a prettier man. Why would you not want to marry him? You think he would expect sex a lot?
Because exactly. He could get into it. I could see him dressing up and
yeah,
let's take turns playing these roles and yeah, and it's like you might be tempted and yeah, he's a good looking guy. But if none of them are ugly. but yeah, he's the prettiest probably out of the three of them.
Okay,
but I think Christian Bale he's
just a dick.
Someone is like,
he needs to be killed.
You need to get rival
the
reasons.
The two people I asked, they agree. Like, the one thing we all agreed on is we would all marry Val Kilmer. We would fuck Michael Keaton. He wanted to just do everything to Adam West, but we all decided that. Well, I guess Joel decided to fuck Christian Bale. But me and Andy decided we would fucking murder Christian Bale. That's plain and simple. We both are going to marry
on that, but you're reversed on the marriage.
Well, yeah, we want to marry Val Kilmer. Yeah. How would you know? If I was doing the man sex, though, I would rather be doing Val
Kilmer.
But like
I said, if you could marry someone who wasn't going to platonically marry you,
yeah,
I think
I'd rather fuck Keaton. Because I feel he would cuddle you. He would take you to dinner. It would be a nice thing. Val Kilmer's just going to fuck the shit out of you. He's gonna rip that ass apart.
I think it's
going
to be a weird thing where he's going to want to fuck you, and he's wearing, like, fucking a maze outfit or something.
He's going to have
like
nipples.
Yeah, not shaved.
And a smaller codpiece.
And like, probably a nice wiener, which, is, like, makes you feel more...
I'd rather have me some Chris O'Donnell. Bring him into the equation.
Yeah, I mean, he's pretty.
He's okay.
It's just not what I want, you know? I like girls.
Yeah. But, all right, everybody. This has been the Park and Lock Podcast.
Not girls, women. I'm too old.
He loves it all, man.
I enjoy females, but that's just my thing. You know, whatever.
All right.
Okay, God love you.
All right.
Doesn't matter.
All right. So here we go. Check this.
I'm with him. I mean, you know.
So, hey, I appreciate you, Reverend Scotty D. You have been the man. This has been, we're fucking wasted. This has been fun. The cameras died. We've had pee breaks. This has been a crazy, probably long podcast. It's been fucking fantastic. I appreciate you standing in and really doing this, because I mean, fuck, why the fuck not? And
what do I have to do?
Hey, man,
I hang out with my cat who wakes me up every time I go to sleep.
Your cat's probably a jerk, but I appreciate you standing in and doing this. I hope you come back. I hope me, you, and Andy can do this. I think the three of us it might be a really long show with what we could have to say. Follow us again on Twitter at parkandlock@twitter.com, I guess. Follow us on Facebook at Park and Lock Podcast. It's probably Park and Lock Podcast on Twitter. Wikipedia.
Wiki.
But yeah, follow us on Facebook, Twitter. Follow me at Scorsty, at ScorstyVZ at Twitter. And hopefully this isn't as sloppy as I'm pretty sure it is, and it has been an ultimately good podcast. I appreciate it.
What's to make it sloppy?
Boom! Thank you!
Peace.